Coach, I know that you're not in the moral victory business, but you brought 59 guys to Athens to play a top 15 team tonight. And I'm just curious, what did you think about the effort that your guys played with?
Really good effort. And I think that this is the best game we've played this year. I was very proud of the way our guys played. Wish we hadn't come up short, but I was really proud of them. This is by a significant margin the best game we've played this year.
I know that your offensive line was able to keep Will upright most of the night, and when they did, he was able to move the ball. But Georgia's defense started to grab hold, especially in that fourth quarter. Was it just an issue where depth became a factor? They had more of it than your guys did. What allowed them to start making plays defensively late in the game?
I think it was depth. I think you hit it right on the head.
Thank you.
All right, guys, if you have any questions, put your name in the chat. Up first, we'll go to Tyler Horka.
Mike, Neil mentioned the, you guys lacking players, and obviously a lot has been made of that number 53. I'm just curious what went into the decision to come into Athens and play in shorthanded like you did.
Well, we're just excited to have a game.
Up next, we'll go to Ben Portnoy.
Mike, you've talked a lot about Will's progress, at least the last few weeks. What did you think
about Will a lot? What?
Will's progress the last few weeks. What did you see from him, and do you feel like tonight was that next step that he took?
I think he's gotten better. I think our O-line took a step this week, which I think was important. I think Will did too. I think as a team, we did. I think we played improved, and I think we played together better tonight than we have some. I mean, and that's what sucks is we fell short. But, it's hard for teams to generally speaking, stay on the field with Georgia. And then, of course, we were shorthanded besides. And so, I think we've got a bunch of young guys who are getting better, and they're going to continue to get better. And we played extremely hard, and I think for the most part.
Up next, let's go to Steve Robertson.
Coach, with all the adversity you had to face this week as a team, what do you feel like you learned about your team this week, not just tonight, but maybe the entire week?
Well, I think there's a determination on our team's part to improve and to get better, and then I think that we're kind of – a lot of those guys on the team are, first of all, have adjusted kind of the first thing but to adjust to is playing college football because we're predominantly freshmen and sophomores. And I mean predominantly, it's crazy. And then somebody had an article, and I didn't realize it was quite this low, but that we have the least amount of returning starters or upperclassmen or something like that in the BCS, but whether that's true or not, they're still really young guys, and I think they've steadily improved. I think they've been pretty committed to improve. I think the guys that's whittled down to now are pretty nitty-gritty guys that make you excited and proud to work with every day.
We'll go back to Tyler.
Mike, when you're preparing for a game like this and you're talking to the guys in the locker room and you know that you're shorthanded, how do you kind of balance that and not making too much of a deal of that and still trying to prepare as you normally do? Or was it harping on that, saying, look, we're shorthanded, but we've got what we got, and we're going to go out there and try to compete?
Next man up, compete with yourself, be the best player you can be, and play together.
Up next, we'll go to Joel Coleman.
I know you've probably hit on this just a little bit, Mike, but when you have a game like this, and obviously we don't know how close this game came to not happening, but now that it has happened and you have this film to point at, and you had 49 scholarship guys that are bought in and all in, how big is this for the future? Just to have this film to point at and say this is what happens when you buy in kind of thing.
I feel like it's pretty big, and I think that because you don't just illustrate it, they can actually feel it as they were involved in it. If you come away with a win, it's even bigger. But you know, the biggest key is to play well. And we did play well today. I mean, the most important thing to do is play well. And I would say this team tonight played as hard and as well, really, you know, with what your best is any team I've ever had. So I've had a lot of great teams. And, yeah, we've beaten some teams. And we've beaten some teams that probably we weren't supposed to beat. But with regard to matching the best of your ability up to whatever the adversity may be, this team may have performed to that level higher than any other team I've coached. So from that standpoint, I'm very proud of them.
Still have time for a few more questions, so if you'll put your name in the chat, we'll get to you. Up next, we'll go back to Ben Portnoy.
Mike, I think tonight you guys averaged a little over 5 yards per first down play. I mean, staying on schedule, it seemed like you guys were able to string together a few more first downs and getting a few more yards on the first and second down. How much, if at all, was that something that's been stressed the last few weeks and just putting yourselves in better positions on third down and maybe picking up first downs earlier in drives?
I think they're byproducts of protecting better, Will reacting to what he sees better, and receivers running more precise routes. And I know that's not a particularly fun answer for your article or whatever. But I think that, you know, over time, it's getting more and more synchronized. And then coupled with that, you know, we were very poised in this game, I thought. You know, people held their head up. People were excited to be out there and compete. And I think there's a lot to draw from this game, and we need to use it to push us forward.
All right, guys, we're going to close with Steve Robertson.
Coach, it seems like in every post-game press conference you've made a comment about your coaches need to coach better. And tonight you haven't made any mention of that. So how do you feel like your coaches kind of handled the week in the ball game tonight?
Well, starting with myself and my assistant coaches, because usually the guy that coaches the worst in these situations is me. I think our players in particular, you know, they deserve the biggest pat on the back, but you know, we're proud to be on a team with them, and proud to be a part of this one. So,
thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you.
All right, guys, we'll have players up shortly.